Starring Leslie Nielsen.
Just can't cover up for you anymore. I'm in this thing way too deep already.
As deep as I am. Oh, honey, please. My bookie's getting anxious.
Well, he wants his money.
Tell him you haven't got it. What can he do?
Tell him you haven't got it.
What can he do?
What can he do? He'd beat up his own mother when it comes to money.
Look, Jimmy, you've got to go along with me or I'm in serious trouble.
I'm sorry.
Or I'm in serious trouble.
All I need is a couple of more days. I'm bound to have a winner.
Or I'm sorry. This is it. The end of the line.
The bands will be off.
All right. I'll think of something. I've got to.
You know I want to help, but with the auditors coming, I've got to balance the books.
But with the auditors coming in, I've got to balance the books.
Good afternoon. Can I help you?
I'd like to cash this, please.
Good afternoon, sir.
Payroll
check?
I'd like to cash this check.
Payroll check?
Yes.
Well,
this is your first time here,
can
I see some identification?
Sure. Mr. Twice?
Yeah, sure. Here's my driver's license.
Enough?
Do you have two major
driver's license? Employee's card? Do fine.
Now, stand on that line and look directly at
the camera.
Come
and see us anytime, Mr. Halper.
All right.
Come and see us anytime, Mr. Weissman.
Aura!
I was across town doing my laundry when I heard the call on the double shooting.
It took me 20 minutes to get there.
My boss was already on the scene.
Hold up, Frank. Cashier's the only witness.
According to one of the shots, she grabbed the gun and shot the bullet.
Can I talk to her?
Sure.
This is Aura Kane, Frank.
Hello.
I'm Captain Frank Revan.
I understand you've had a pretty rough time.
Yeah, it was pretty bad.
Well, you feel up to any questions?
You feel up to answering some questions. But where were you when all this happened? I was right here at my desk working. When was the first time you noticed that something was wrong? Well, when I first heard the shot, as I turned, Jim fell.
He's the teller, Frank. Jim fell the teller?
No, Jim Johnson.
He's such a wonderful guy that when I stopped to think that he
had the flu, so Jim filled in. What did you do, though?
I filled in. He's the night watchman, Frank.
Fully fill in.
The man turned toward me. I was so sure he was going to kill me that...
Twice came in and shot the teller, Jim fell.
No, he only shot the teller, Jim Johnson.
And I shot
his ill.
Okay, then after he shot the teller, you shot twice.
No, I only shot once.
He ran out the back door into the
Twice is the holdup man.
Could you possibly describe him for us?
Well, so now you're changing the story.
I shot twice after Jim fell.
You shot twice and Jim fell?
No, Jim fell first, and then I shot twice once.
And he wore dirty gray pants and nuts.
He's the owner of the tire company, Frank.
Well, that's a very good description.
Once is the owner of the tire company, he fired twice. And twice shot the teller once.
Twice.
And Jim fell, and then you fired twice.
Don't let appearances fool you. In just about 2 minutes.
All right, that'll be all for now, Miss Decker.
Now, we'll need you to make a formal statement down at the station.
Miss Kane. Oh, of course.
But that can be very helpful. I'll have someone drive you home. I did it.
Oh, Howie couldn't have done it. He hasn't been in for weeks.
Well, thank you again, Mr.
See you later, Frank.
Sally Decker told a convincing story. I thought she would make a good witness if the case ever came to trial. A criminal investigation seldom follows a straightforward, clear-cut course. This one was obviously no exception. I felt we had to talk with Ralph Twice's widow.
Go away. Please go away. I don't want to answer any more of your questions.
Well, we're sorry to bother you at a time like this, Mrs. Twice. We would have come earlier if your husband wasn't dead then.
Do you know what it's like to be married to a wonderful man for 14 years?
Did he owe any money? Doctor bills? Gambling debts? Book of the month club?
There's only one possible answer. Ralph didn't do it.
Two more payments on our silver telescope.
I know Ralph was such a good man.
Who could have done such a horrible thing?
The law needs a better answer than that.
Poor Ralph. And what about my daughter? What am I going to tell her?